Hello everyone and welcome to our channel. We're excited to have you here with us today as we explore unbelievable fishing, Chinese fishermen catching fish with cormorants, and life cycle of cormorant from egg to adult. Please ensure that you watch this video until the very end, as we have something extraordinary to reveal to you. So sit back, relax, and let's get started. In China, fishermen have been using cormorants for centuries to help catch fish. These skilled birds have a unique ability to dive underwater and catch fish with their sharp beaks, making them valuable partners to Chinese fishermen. The practice of using cormorants for fishing dates back to ancient China, where it was used as a traditional method of catching fish in rivers and lakes. The fishermen would train the cormorants from a young age to swim alongside their boats and catch fish for them. Over time, this partnership between man and bird became a well-established tradition in Chinese fishing culture. The cormorants used for fishing in China are typically the great cormorant species, known for their excellent fishing abilities. These birds have long bodies, webbed feet, and sharp beaks that make them well suited for diving and catching fish underwater. They are also trained to return the fish they catch to the fishermen, who in turn reward them with small fish as a token of appreciation. The process of using cormorants for fishing begins with the fishermen taking their trained birds out on the water in their boats. The cormorants wear small rings around their necks to prevent them from swallowing larger fish, allowing them to catch multiple fish before needing to return to the surface. The fishermen then release the birds into the water, where they dive and swim alongside the boat in search of fish. As the cormorants catch fish, they bring them back to the surface and hold them in their beaks. The fishermen then use a special technique to retrieve the fish from the cormorants without harming them. This process is repeated multiple times until the cormorants have caught enough fish for the fishermen to bring back to shore. Using cormorants for fishing requires a great deal of skill and patience on the part of both the fishermen and the birds. It takes years of training for the cormorants to become proficient at catching fish, and the fishermen must also develop a strong bond with their avian companions in order to work effectively together. One of the key benefits of using cormorants for fishing is their ability to dive to depths that humans cannot reach, making them ideal for catching fish in deep waters. They are also able to navigate through narrow passages and dense vegetation, allowing them to catch fish in areas that are inaccessible to traditional fishing methods. Cormorants are a type of water bird found in many parts of the world, including China. They are known for their distinctive hooked beaks and ability to dive underwater to catch fish. Cormorants have been used in China for centuries to help fishermen catch fish. Today, there are an estimated 10,000 cormorant fishermen in China, and they use these birds to catch millions of fish each year. Life cycle. Cormorants typically mate for life and build their nests in trees or on cliffs near water. The female cormorant lays 2 to 6 eggs, which are incubated by both parents for around 4 to 5 weeks. Once the chicks hatch, they are fed and cared for by both parents until they fledge and become independent, usually after around 6 to 8 weeks. Feeding. Cormorants are piscivorous, meaning that they primarily eat fish. They use their sharp beaks to catch fish underwater, and they can dive to depths of up to 30 feet (9.14 meters). Cormorants typically eat 1 to 2 pounds (0.45 kilograms, 0.9 kilograms) of fish per day. Training. Cormorant fishermen train their birds to catch fish by attaching a ring around the bird's neck. This ring prevents the bird from swallowing the fish it catches. The fishermen then take the birds out on boats and allow them to dive for fish. The birds are trained to return to the boat with the fish they catch. Fishing. Cormorant fishing is a traditional practice in China that has been passed down for generations. Cormorant fishermen typically use small boats to take their birds out to fishing spots. The birds are then allowed to dive for fish, and the fishermen collect the fish that the birds catch. Cormorant fishing is a sustainable practice, as the birds only catch fish that they can eat. Cormorants are an important part of the Chinese ecosystem. They help to control fish populations and they provide a livelihood for cormorant fishermen. However, cormorants are also threatened by habitat loss and pollution. Conservation efforts are underway to protect cormorants and their habitats. Cormorants are fascinating creatures that have played an important role in Chinese culture and history. They are skilled fishermen and they provide a valuable service to cormorant fishermen. Conservation efforts are underway to protect cormorants and their habitats so that they can continue to thrive in China for generations to come. Cormorants are found in both freshwater and saltwater habitats. Cormorants are social birds and they often live in colonies. Cormorants are territorial and they will defend their nests and feeding grounds from other birds. Cormorants are long-lived birds and they can live for up to 20 years. Cormorants are protected by law in China. Specialized adaptations. Cormorants have several adaptations that aid in their fishing success. Webbed feet. Their webbed feet provide excellent propulsion for swimming and maneuvering underwater. Dense bones. Their bones are denser than those of most birds, which helps them sink below the water's surface. Sharp beak. Their slightly hooked beak is perfect for grasping and holding slippery fish. Waterlogged feathers. While their feathers are not waterproof, they become waterlogged, reducing buoyancy and allowing the birds to dive deeper.
Come on,
In China, the traditional practice of raising cormorants for fishing has been passed down through generations. Here is a detailed description of the stages in the process of raising cormorants from egg to adult for fishing purposes. 1. Egg acquisition. Cormorant fishermen typically obtain cormorant eggs from wild nests or breed their own captive cormorants to produce eggs. The eggs are carefully collected and placed in a safe, controlled environment to ensure their successful incubation. 2. Incubation. The collected cormorant eggs are carefully incubated either by the fishermen themselves or using artificial incubators. The eggs are kept at a consistent temperature and humidity level throughout the incubation period, which usually lasts around 4 to 5 weeks. 3. Hatching. Once the incubation period is complete, the cormorant eggs hatch, and the chicks emerge. The newly hatched chicks are fragile and require careful attention and care to ensure their survival. 4. Nestling stage. The young cormorant chicks are raised by the fishermen, who provide them with food, protection, and guidance. During this stage, the chicks grow rapidly and develop their feathers, learning to trust and bond with their human caretakers. 5. Training. As the cormorant chicks grow, they are gradually introduced to the art of fishing. The fishermen teach the young cormorants how to swim, dive, and catch fish using their natural instincts. Through patient training and positive reinforcement, the cormorants learn to associate fishing with rewards. 6. Fishing with cormorants. Once the cormorants have been trained and have developed their fishing skills, they are ready to accompany the fishermen on fishing expeditions. The cormorants dive into the water, catch fish, and bring them back to the fishermen. The bond between the fishermen and their cormorants is crucial during this stage, as trust and communication are essential for successful fishing. 7. Adult stage. As the cormorants mature and gain experience in fishing, they become valuable assets to the fishermen. Adult cormorants are skilled hunters, able to catch fish efficiently and contribute to the success of the fishing operation. The fishermen continue to care for and train their cormorants throughout their adult lives, ensuring a strong partnership between bird and human. The process of raising cormorants from egg to adult in China for fishing purposes is a unique and time-honored tradition that showcases the deep connection between humans and nature. Through careful care, training, and respect for the natural abilities of the cormorants,
你在这儿啊。五六天了。这晒差不多了哈，再把它盖起来，盖起来再放到阴凉的地方。 小云已经晒好了太阳啊，放到阴凉的地方去啊，这里面小云。 少。这是真正的最后一勺，已经给大家伙吃完了。
拿遗书的，那叫什么？
看看这个半个月的这个，
长得一斤半左右吧，
一斤半。看看脸，哟，像像 小骆驼，像不像？
The process of raising and training cormorants for fishing by Chinese fishermen is a time-honored tradition that requires patience, skill, and dedication. Below is a step-by-step guide to how Chinese fishermen raise and train cormorants for fishing. Step 1. Acquisition of cormorant chicks. The process begins with the acquisition of cormorant chicks, typically from the wild or through captive breeding programs. Cormorant chicks are usually obtained when they are around 4 to 6 months old, as this is the optimal age for training. Step 2. Bonding with the cormorants. Establishing a bond of trust between the cormorants and their handlers is crucial for successful training. Fishermen start by keeping the cormorants in close proximity to them and regularly feeding them to build a relationship based on positive reinforcement. Step 3. Basic training. The basic training of cormorants involves familiarizing them with their surroundings, getting them comfortable with human contact, and teaching them basic commands. This stage is essential for building trust and establishing a foundation for more advanced training. Step 4. Introduction to water. Cormorants are introduced to water gradually, starting with shallow areas and progressing to deeper waters. This step helps the birds become accustomed to swimming and diving, essential skills for fishing. Step 5. Introducing fishing techniques. Once the cormorants are comfortable in the water, fishermen begin teaching them fishing techniques. This includes instructing the birds on how to dive underwater, catch fish, and return to the boat with their catch. Step 6. Using training tools. Fishermen use training tools such as snares or rings placed around the cormorants, next to assist in fishing training. These tools allow the birds to swallow small fish while preventing them from swallowing larger fish or escaping with their catch. The fisherman can then retrieve the fish from the cormorant's throat and reward the bird for its efforts. Step 7. Command training. Through verbal commands and hand signals, fishermen teach the cormorants to respond to cues during fishing trips. The birds learn when to dive, when to catch fish, and when to return to the boat based on these commands. Consistent practice and reinforcement help the cormorants develop the necessary skills for effective fishing. Step 8. Regular exercise and practice. Training cormorants for fishing is a lifelong process that requires regular exercise and practice to maintain their skills. Fishermen work closely with their birds to ensure they stay healthy, happy, and well-trained for fishing trips. This ongoing bond between the birds and their handlers is essential for the success of cormorant fishing. Step 9. Continued support and care. After the cormorants have been trained for fishing, fishermen provide continued support and care to ensure the birds' well-being. Regular checkups, proper nutrition, and attention to the birds' physical and mental health are essential to maintaining a successful partnership between the fishermen and their cormorants. By following these steps and dedicating time and effort to the training process, Chinese fishermen can raise and train cormorants for fishing successfully. The bond between the birds and their handlers, coupled with consistent training and care, ensures the cormorants are skilled and well-equipped for traditional fishing practices in China.
第八条，第九条。
第十五条，兄弟们，慢了，你得注意点业务，我一弄。奖励啊，兄弟们，一分钟内狂上15条鱼，第16条了，兄弟们。 还有17条，18条鱼了。兄弟们，看看今天到底能抓多少。 19条鱼，两个，20条鱼来了，21条鱼，22条鱼，23条鱼，24条鱼，25条鱼。 26条鱼，27条，28，29条。30条，第31条，33条，
啊，
30几条来，我都忘了。又上一条，又来一条。
哎，老李，36条，
36条了，37条，38条，连续上鱼。39，40，41。你看，把海鸥都吸引来了。42条。43，能不能抓到50条？46啊，还有4条，好的，47，
差3条，
48条，很大了，结束。哎，今天下午太猛了，也就两三分钟吧，上了50条，50条鱼算4斤一条，200斤应该到了。
闪电，一阵子就闪电。在那打吃猫的时候就吃。
吃完还要喝点水，
耍耍嘴，
喝汤，
耍耍嘴。
怪极了，这这么老，这么从老下去，满满的一大盆呢。
三只鹰过来了，那边都在蠢蠢欲动。再加入一只。都不吃了，
都不找吃的。你这样大你吃下去。
厉害！
一般鱼不跟
过海的哦。
有的不能想吃，但大多数都是狼吞虎咽。
坐了就得想吃。
那这是坐月子的。
坐月子。生蛋的乖。
两个生蛋的鱼。坐月子要多给吃点。
好嘞，你来吃。
跟吃瓜子似
的。来了来了。这边
吃吧。
喂的。
马上见底了。还有几只吧，还有几条鱼吧，最后人工喂一下。
这都是中鹰。
中鹰要多给吃点。
走了走了，前面修路了，我们过不去了。哇哦！
我的主意，
厉害了啊、哦、一个个的你看多厉害，加油加油
加油加油加油啊，
快加油、
啊、过了，
漂亮，还有这个你看你看厉害不厉害，
你看三个可以，
哇，看看看，上货了，哇，漂亮，呀呀呀，哇，哎，这是条墨鱼，
鲶鱼，
大鲶鱼一条，漂亮啊，活蹦乱跳的啊，给力，哇，活蹦乱跳的鲶鱼，可以。哇，前面又来鱼了，看看看啊、哦！哎呀，哎呀，厉害厉害厉害，精彩精彩，太精彩了！哇，哎呦呦呦，快快快，上来上来上来！大混战呢，在前面。哎呀哎呀，吃进去吧，漂亮，哇哇漂亮，两二三斤重的鲤鱼，哇活蹦乱跳的，漂亮，准备回城。
不画了，
不画了。
在差不多都已经装车了，我们马上就要回去了。今天收获还可以，兄弟们，户外拍摄不易啊，别忘了收藏、点赞、加转发，我们下次再见吧。
要不要把它剁碎？
不剁，不剁。
一只鱼要吃多少只鱼？
吃一斤啊！
一斤有多少条啊？
一斤有十几条吧。
十五六条。
来了来了来了！我上岸喽！行了。
后边一只大鱼啊，跟着过来。每只鱼都要吃一斤的鱼啊，差不多这有20多斤。32只鱼，三十多斤鱼。吃完了也不吵不闹了。几只稍微小一点的吧。这小鱼它应该吃的少一点，要不要吃不了一斤啊？
吃不了
3两，也要8两，这差不多嘛，没多大区别。没有多少鱼了，
鱼不多了。
还有这一只，喂了。30斤鱼喂下去之后，整个世界一片安静。
Daily life of a cormorant in China. Dawn. As the first rays of dawn pierce through the morning mist, a cormorant awakens from its slumber in a bustling colony nestled amidst the serene waters of a Chinese lake. Its sleek, Dark feathers glisten with dew as it stretches its powerful wings and prepares for the day ahead. With a chorus of raucous calls echoing through the air, the colony erupts into a frenzy of activity. Cormorants of all ages take flight, their long necks extended and their piercing eyes scanning the water's surface for signs of their next meal. Morning hunt. The cormorant is a skilled hunter, renowned for its adeptness in diving and pursuing fish underwater. As it soars above the lake, its keen eyesight detects a ripple in the water below. With lightning reflexes, it plunges into the depths, its hooked beak poised to seize its prey. Submerging effortlessly, the cormorant propels itself through the water with powerful strokes of its webbed feet. Its streamlined body allows it to navigate underwater with remarkable agility, chasing after elusive fish with unwavering determination. Midday rest. After a successful morning hunt, the cormorant returns to its perch on a nearby rock or tree branch. It spends the midday hours resting and digesting its meal, its feathers ruffled in contentment. As the sun reaches its zenith, the colony becomes a hive of activity once more. Cormorants take to the skies in search of new hunting grounds, while others engage in playful interactions, their raucous calls filling the air. Afternoon fishing. As the afternoon shadows lengthen, the cormorant embarks on its second hunting expedition of the day. It soars over the lake, its keen eyes scanning the water below. When it spots a promising target, it dives with precision, its beak aimed directly at its prey. With each dive, the cormorant demonstrates its remarkable hunting prowess. Its ability to hold its breath for extended periods allows it to pursue fish into their underwater hiding spots, often emerging victorious with a wriggling fish clamped firmly in its beak. Evening return. As dusk descends, the cormorant makes its way back to the colony, its belly full and its feathers damp from a day spent hunting. It joins its fellow cormorants on the communal roost. Thank you for watching. We appreciate your time and attention. Please subscribe to our channel and don't forget to like, comment and hit the notification bell to stay updated on our latest videos. We look forward to seeing you again soon.